Hello, this is the first video I've ever made, so I'm sorry if it's a little bit janky. Please let me know if there's anything I can do to improve, but I just wanted to make this tutorial so you could figure out how to put your own music on your Wii U's theme. It's not too bad, but it is a little bit of a lengthy process and can get confusing. Things you're going to need are Citric Composer, Sequence Convert, SDCafiine. You're going to need your Unmodified Cafe Barista Min file. I'll show you what that is in a little bit if you don't remember. You're going to need an audio program for converting your audio files to WAV format. So Audacity works really well for that. You'll need a ROM patcher, which I have a website for that I'll put in the description, as well as a text editor like VS Code or PyCharm. The last thing that you need is Discord to join the Theme Cafe server, as you'll need files from them later on. Let's get into it. The first thing you're going to need to do is navigate to your Cafe Barista min file. Make sure you have it. Know where it's at. I am very good at losing things, so please don't be like me. But that's definitely what you're going to need. It should be with these min packs that you got originally when you started making your theme. If you don't have it, you will have to go back and get it. I might make a video on how to do that eventually. I just am not sure right now, but I'm gonna go with this assuming that you already have that file, and this is what you need to do this entire process essentially. So we're gonna put that off to the side for now and go on from there. Okay, so what we're going to do from here is go to Audacity. And I'm going to be doing a Twilight Princess theme, so my music is going to be the intro to that. I'm going to go ahead and click out of that, open file, navigate to the music I'm choosing. And I want to mention that you need to keep your music around 1 minute long. I grabbed the wrong file here originally, so I had to go back and change this, but the process is still the same. But you're going to export the audio, save it to your computer. It should automatically become a WAV file. All you're gonna do now is just export that. We're finished with Audacity, so we can exit out. We don't need to save anything. And we're gonna learn how to get Citric Composer now. I'm gonna put this link in the description, but you just download the Citric Composer installer and follow it as you would any other EXE. From there, we're gonna need Sequence Convert as well. Same thing, download. But don't run the EXE for this one. I'll explain that a little bit further on in the video. It'll make sense then. From there, we're gonna get the ROM patcher. This top one is going to be your original Cafe Barista min file, and that's what we're gonna put up there. This bottom one here is what we need to get from the Discord server where all of these themes are made. It's called Theme Cafe. I'll put a link in the description to them below, but from here you're going to grab this cafebarista.bps file and download that. Now you're going to go back to the patch file and put this one on the bottom that you just got. I'm putting the original that I grabbed, and you should have this patched file show up now. And I'm going to go ahead and open this in my folder just so I can keep track of where it's at. I don't usually name these, rename them until the end, because I will lose them, but we're going to open Citric Composer, and from here, we're going to go over and put in the new one we just made. We're going to go over to WAV Archives, down to this first one, and from here, we're going to hit the plus by this, and we're going to scroll all the way down until we find 302. You're going to know you did this right if you see all these null waves around. If you don't see them, you probably did not patch it correctly. Make sure your original is on top and the one provided by the Discord is the one on bottom. So the top one would be BFSAR and the bottom would be .bps. But anyways, we're going to take this, and this is where we're going to be putting our WAV file that we made earlier in Audacity. So go locate that real quick. Let it load. The name should change to unknown wave name, and then you can just save, and we're going to exit up. From here, we're going to go over to sound sequences, open that up, and scroll all the way down until you find 371 and 372. These are going to be what controls the audio and loop If you don't do this process, your music won't loop correctly. So just go save these in a safe place, keep track of them, make sure you export both of them. And from here, we're gonna head over to our own text editor. So like PyCharm or VS Code, either of those will work. We're gonna open up Sequence Convert that we got earlier, as well as those files we just exported. From here, all you're gonna do, it is surprisingly simple, is you're gonna grab these two files and you're gonna drag and drop them over the Sequence Convert. And that's gonna change it into files that can be read by the text editor. From here, we're just gonna drag and drop them in. And what we're gonna be paying attention to is this little section right here, specifically this line. This first number, this 120, is what controls the volume, but you don't need to change that. The second one right here is what we care about. This is what controls the loop of the music, and this is what we're going to need to change for both of these files we just exported. So what we need to do is check how long our music is that we put in the first place. So you're going to want to go find that audio that you had. That up, check how long it is, and we're going to be doing some decently simple math. So mine's not very long, it's 1:07, so that's 67 seconds. And what we're going to do with that is multiply it by 192. What this does is give you the number that you need to put in this place. And no matter the length of your audio, you're still going to multiply it by 192 no matter what. It's just the length of your audio might be different, so make sure you convert it into seconds and then multiply that. So you can put that in place. We're going to go ahead and save that as well. And then we're going to do the exact same thing with the other file. The first thing I do though is check and make sure it's changed, and it has. I'm gonna drag and drop, do the same thing. It's gonna be the same number. And then we're gonna go over and save. We're gonna X out of that. And then we're gonna take these files, check, make sure they have changed. Yep. I'm gonna delete these two so I don't get confused with myself. And then we're going to get Sequence Convert back out. And we're going to take and drop them over it again. From here, we're going to open Citric Composer back up. And what we're going to do is replace these files with the ones we just made. Right click, replace, and make sure that you have the correct files. And the title should stay the same and everything like that. One thing you might do though is check this file right here, the synth, go to edit and make sure the volume's set at 0. If not, it could give you some issues later on. But that's all we need to do in there. We can save it. I just want to check first, make sure that my files are edited how they're supposed to be. Yep, we're all good to go. Close out of that. And from here, we just need to go to our SD card and go ahead and put that where it's supposed to be. We're going to follow the Wii U SDCafiine, the region I believe is what it is. I'm gonna click on my Twilight Princess one since that's what I'm working on. Content, common, sound, and this min. And you're gonna have your original file here. Please back it up because it would suck to lose and have to do all of this again. So feel free to back it up wherever is most convenient for you. This is a backup of my original Twilight Princess one I made. So I'm just gonna put that off to the side. And from here, you're gonna drag and drop in the new one you edited. Make sure you rename it, take out the patched portion. hit enter, and you're all finished here. Now just eject this, and we're gonna head over to the Wii U. All right, we're gonna let this load in. Go and select the mod pack that you're working on. I'm gonna go select mine, and we should be good to go. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them down below. Feel free to leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Let me know if you didn't, if there's anything I can improve on, and I will do my best. I am a bit busy, but I will try to get more content out there eventually. I hope you enjoyed, and have a great rest of your day.